Today I'm making a commando droid. For this build, you'll need EVA foam floor mats. What a surprise. Quarter inch EVA foam, which you can get in rolls. Various glues, paint, leftover spray paint lids, gray plastidip, scrap wood, a saw, a drill, sanding materials, safety gear, scissors, razor pens, and a box cutter. First off, I'm going to start where I left off last time and build this hip part at the base of the spine. I cut a rough shape from a sheet of blue EVA foam for some idiotic reason. Honestly, the commando droids, if you just make out a regular gray EVA foam, then you don't have to paint. But I'm trying to ration the large gray pieces for the legs just for the surface area. So blue. I cut a sort of teardrop shape to go in the center with a notch in the elongated end so that it would lock into the spine. I made a copy to make it double thick. Before gluing it on, I used it to help figure out the dimensions of the hips, pelvis, I don't know, it's a robot, whatever. Once I had gotten those, I cut a hole out of the center and glued it onto the smallest spine section. Oh, I better cover this right now, otherwise I'm never gonna hear the end of it. Take it away, InCam Jake.
So I rarely use hot glue for this sort of thing anymore. This is because I'm setting up a dedicated contact cement workstation, and the ventilation system is not installed yet. So right now it's just a poison room. It's just a room full of flammable poison. But I have had hot glue props that have held up for the better part of a decade. How old's Chopper? I don't think there's any contact cement in Chopper.
But occasionally I'll use super glue, like on the exterior pelvis panel. Super glue is great on EVA foam, except it doesn't flex. That has yet to be a problem for me, but I'll let you know, or future Jake will let you know. Those seams are a bit too pronounced, so I'm gonna fill them in with DAP Alex Fast Dry. I glued the whole assembly together and then moved on to the joints. For those, I'm using spent spray paint caps attached with super glue. I put extra foam circles in there just to increase the surface area that the glue will have to grip onto. Then I drilled holes in the tops of the paint cans so that I could make the legs hinge. I felt like the shape wasn't quite right, so I added these crescent pieces cut from regular craft foam. This definitely gave it more dimensionality. Plus, it'll make it harder to see the diamond pattern on the inside once the whole thing is done. Although if you have the time, you could sand that off. It just didn't occur to me. I find that the fast dry filler, really most fillers, shrinks as it dries, so I had to do multiple applications over the course of the day. Although it should be noted that if you cut into the foam at an angle so that the two edges meet up correctly to begin with, then you're less likely to need to fill in the seams later. I coated that with gray plastidip and then moved on to the legs. This is a rough template. I'll eventually have them available to you in my Etsy store, link below, but I need to refine them first so that they don't waste printer ink. You guys don't need to print cardboard. I used my original battle droid legs as a jumping off point. For the battle droid, I was attempting to reach a level of detail somewhere in between the animated series and the movies, and all that is I like the shape of the animated head a lot better than the movie head, but I do like the movie level of detail. I think I achieved what I was going for the most part. However, I was never really satisfied with the legs. They just look a little flat. So this time around, I'm going for a more three-dimensional look. Too far. Not quite so three-dimensional. Plus, that level of detail costs an arm and a leg. kill me now. In order to accomplish this, after tracing them onto the sheet of EVA foam and cutting them out, I'll be using an angle cutter. This is a tool that uses two blades oriented at an angle to cut a notch in the foam at a variable depth. Once the notches were cut, I simply placed a line of glue in the trench and folded the foam shut on itself, just like a book. It will take a few minutes for the glue to cool down, so I held it in that shape with weights and moved on to the next aspect of the build, which would be the shin bone, I guess. I'm not a droid anatomist, clearly. I cut a piece of scrap wood to length and then a dowel for the ankle hinge.
This shot is so that you guys can get the dimensions. Although I cannot stress this enough, it doesn't matter. I always get asked the dimensions of the PVC pipe on the battle droid video, and it doesn't matter.
Because of the angled shape of the outside of the leg, I'm going to need to sand the corner edges of that piece of wood flat again if they're gonna work as a joint. I did this using my belt sander, like my dust collection system. So professional. One thing at a time, guys, it's a new shop. Now this is gonna put a lot of sawdust into the air, which will hang there for hours. So while I'm doing this, I'm gonna be wearing a dust mask and then just leave that area of the shop until the dust settles. When it was flat enough, I drilled a hole for the hinge pin. I started out with a small drill bit to make a pilot hole because I don't want the wood to splinter. Then I moved up to a much larger drill bit, and son of a— alright, so clearly more staging would have been necessary. But it's all good, got plenty of wood glue. I started by gluing in the dowel with wood glue, and then I clamped it in place. That'll have to stay like that for at least a few hours, but through the magic of editing, we can get straight down to setting it into the shin. And oddly enough, my old-timey machinist blocks worked out great here, just because they're angled, and this is the exact perfect angle for this. So I hot glued that down. I actually think that even if the ventilation system was up and running, I'd still use hot glue here because it's foam to wood, not foam to foam. While waiting for various glues to dry, I secretly made 3 more shin panels off camera, making sure that half of them were mirrored. You don't want all 4 to be the same. So I took one of those mirrored ones and used it to finish the leg. Again, I utilized the weight of the machinist blocks to help hold it down. These also help draw some of the heat away from the foam, because metal just does that for some science reason. This has been Science Facts with William Shakespeare. So I'm using these machinist blocks a lot for this build just because that's how it worked out. But I do want to point out that a fan actually sent me some 1-2-3 blocks.
Just want to give a quick shout out to Dante, who was so, let's say, moved by my 1-2-3 blocks joke that he sent me a couple of actual 1-2-3 blocks. Whoa, I can smell the chemicals. Oh, and they're threaded. That'll come in handy.
Oh, they're greasy. They are so greasy. Thanks, man.
Nah, it's cool. So those are gonna have to be degreased before I use them on foam, but still. And I can't touch the camera with these greasy fingers. So once again, thank you, Dante.
All right, so it looks like cleaning the grease off of that is gonna be a project in and of itself. So for now, we're gonna stick with the old-timey MC Escher ones. I cover the front and back seam of the shim with 2mm craft foam. And that's it for the shin. Now onto the feet. These are a lot more complex than regular Battle Droid feet, so I figured out all the shapes ahead of time and then traced them onto various pieces of scrap EVA foam. For the heel, I use the thickest foam I have, which is from a sheet of half-inch linking foam floor mats. For the internal structure, I used 3 layers of 3/8-inch thick linking foam floor mat. That's one with the diamond pattern on the back. I left an open space in the center so that the end of the shin bone would have room to swing back and forth. And for all the in-between pieces, I used 1/4-inch craft foam and just some random pieces here and there. For instance, I heat-formed a small strip to get the curve in the back of the heel. I'm not sure if there are actually treads on the soles of the feet of commando droids, but occasionally the foam texture just works as extra detail in certain places, so I'm using it. I'm not gonna lie, there was a lot of guesswork involved in this, and you can see there are areas where I messed up and had to put in spacers to make it work. So if you guys run into any issues while building this, it happens to everybody. Just work the problem until you find a solution. You never want to just give up entirely, because once it's finished, no one is gonna see the inside, so as long as it's structurally sound, what's the difference? I filled in the rest of the empty panels. I added foam circles to either side of the ankle in order to hide the hinge pins, and also because it's visually accurate. Then I attached the foot to the shin at the ankle point. And before painting, I'm gonna do a poor man's heat seal with my heat gun in order to stop the foam from absorbing the first layer of paint. And like I said earlier, if you decide to build yours out of EVA foam that's all the same shade of gray, then you don't have to paint. So just keep that in mind. However, because I used all different shades and even some black foam, I'm gonna need to even it all out a bit with gray Plastidip. Also, before I shot this, I built a prototype and made every mistake you could possibly imagine. I mean, God, just look at that. Look at all that filler. So that definitely needs to be covered up. I painted those outside. While it was drying, I went back and painted the hip joints copper to match the shoulder joints.
You know, as I'm doing this, it occurs to me that it would have been better. I mean, this color would have come through better if I had used white spray paint caps as a base instead of black ones, but I can't always choose the color that runs out first, you know what I mean?
Then I went along all the leg edges with rub and buff wax metallic finish to make it look like the top layer of paint had worn away to reveal the metal beneath.
Which does actually match the art scheme of the show. There should actually be a lot on the inside because that's where the most friction will be, but no one's gonna really see that. So trying to avoid stuff like that where you can clearly see it's a fingerprint. And when I do accidentally get a huge smudge like that, I gotta widen the whole thing to match. But at any rate, I think that the rub and buff adds character.
Additionally, I put some black paint in all the grooves, partially to make it look like weathering, but also to cover up the wood. And that's how you make a commando droid. Wait, I forgot the hips. I'm out of time.
Quick, what's quick last minute substitute? Seriously, anything at all.
Note to self. Commando droid parts are not interchangeable with Samus Aran.
I drew an oval shape onto my last sheet of gray EVA foam. Then I used the angle cutter to make folds the same way I did the shin pieces. I glued those folds together. I extrapolated the shape of the hip. Unlike the shins, this has to be rounded because the designers were trying to more closely match the dimensions of a person so that the droids could fit inside the clone's armor. I added some structural pieces so that the thigh would hold its shape while I worked on it. Then I drew this shape onto a large piece of 1/4-inch craft foam. Roll foam. 1/4-inch roll foam. There we go. I cut it out and heat formed it onto a concave surface. Then I glued the top end pieces together before attaching it to the rest of the leg. I put this inset spherical piece in the opening first. I think it's supposed to be a ball and socket joint or something. Then I attached it to the upper leg structure. Now that that was finished, I duplicated the process for the opposite side. Then I plasti-dipped them. When they had aired out, I attached some scrap foam to the leg, threaded it through the opening in the hip joint, and attached it to the leg on the other side. Then I attached the shins to each knee. I matched the weathering with the shins, and now I was finished. Thanks for watching, everyone! This video was only made possible because of my patrons, however, it took 7 months because I don't have enough. So if you'd like to see these larger builds happen in a more timely fashion, then consider following the Patreon link in the description down below. Any amount you're able to donate will help me improve the speed, quality, and scale of both the prop and the video in which it's presented. Alright, happy crafting! See you later!